It's main event time here on FS1 as we get right to the Corona tail of the tape. The unbeaten Jamal Shango James taking on Javier Molina. Look at the height, the reach difference for Jamal James. Let's see if that plays the major part in this fight. Both our fighters are in the ring. We get the official introduction from Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Club Nokia here in Los Angeles, California, Premier Boxing Champions now features the main event live on FS1, 10 rounds in the welterweight division. The three judges ringside are Sergio Caiz, Dr. Lou Moretz, and Zachary Young. And the referee in charge, when the bell sounds, Thomas Taylor. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white with the U.S. and the Mexican flags as his trim. His professional record, 17 wins, 8 of those coming by way of knockout against one loss. Fighting out of Norwalk, California, he is the 2008 United States Olympian, Javier El Intocable Molina. Across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the green trunks as a professional, undefeated, 18 bouts, 18 victories, 9 of those coming by way of knockouts. Fighting out of Burnsville by way of Minneapolis, Minnesota. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Jamal Shango James.
Boxer Chief second. Boxer Chief second. Okay, guys, belt line's a little high here, guys. I'm gonna let them work right here. Belt's good. Protect yourselves at all times. Listen to my commands, guys. Touch them up. Back to your corner.
Show, baby.
Go back.
Well, once again, it bears repeating. California rules different, a little different from the unified rules. No standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. Referee or doctor can't stop the fight. Fighter can't be saved by the bell in any round except the last round. And this fight is official at the beginning of the fourth round. If it's stopped in the middle, you go to the scorecards. This is round one of our main event. Jamal Shango James, he's got the green trunks. Javier Molina in the white trunks with the black trim.
This is going to be a fight between two prospects turned really good pros. One is still undefeated, the other one only has one lone loss. Jamal is very confident. Both fighters that come from a fighting family, this is going to be a good main event.
As I see, Molina is probably in better shape than he's always been. He looks very good and very focused. That's one thing that I see right away. He's very focused, so I see him, you know, taking this seriously. Maybe he didn't in the past, but now he's serious. I think that loss taught him a lot.
Molina, you hear the crowd. They've already been cheering for him. And from Norwalk, about 25, 29 minutes here from where we are.
I noticed that too, Robert, by the way. I'm sorry. Right now, he's in good shape. Some fighters don't have that muscular tone of the big muscles or being lean and ripped up. Molina looks really lean right now, but this is the best I've seen him in a long time as well. I had him in camp sparring a couple of times, and it's his timing. He doesn't really need muscles because he's not a physical fighter, but right now he's in the best shape of his life, I would say.
Halfway through round one, he talked about how important this fight was for him. He said, listen, this is my first main event. I'm here in LA, in my hometown. In fact, I'm in the building where basically I started my pro career. First fight was here. There's a double left hook that sends Shango James to the ropes.
And he's near his hometown, so he has a lot of people here rooting him on. But Jamal doesn't care. He's the undefeated fighter. He says, I'll go in and win a fight. Both fighters are expecting a big fight and a knockout to tell you.
Stiff jab there by James. Molina is really hobbled by hand problems, especially his right hand. Said it hurt him really for more than 2 years. Had two metal plates put in that right hand. He broke that hand four times. There's a right hand by James.
Good counter right there by James. He caught Molina coming in.
30 seconds left. Up to the body by Molina.
Great body shot by Molina there.
Yeah, you can see Molina is the most determined fighter to do a good job here. You know, he's focused, he's ready to go, and I'm sure he's in shape for those tough 10 rounds.
Final seconds here of round one of our main event. Molina lets his hands go. Here's the exchange. Molina left to the body. That one sent James to the ropes. We got a special guest with us when we come back. Welcome back to Los Angeles. It's our main event. Jamal James taking on Javier Molina. Well, in the main event Saturday night, Danny Garcia will take on Robert Guerrero. Before they fight, you'll see this young man. Talk about one of the rising stars in the welterweight division. Sammy Vasquez will step into the ring against Aaron Martinez. How are you, Sam?
Good, good. How are you doing?
How do you like the fighting thus far?
I'll tell you what, both of these guys are very strong. They both came to step up the competition, and it's an exciting fight.
Well, we will see you Saturday night taking on Aaron Martinez. You want to talk about a tough, rugged guy in the welterweight division coming off a win against Devin Alexander. Toughest guy you fought this far in your career?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, I mean, he brings it. He comes to bring it. He has a lot of heart, a lot of grit. And, we've been working on a lot of things, and I intend to stop him.
Wow. What do you think a win against a guy like Martinez would do for you?
Huge. I mean, he beat Devin Alexander, who was a world champion. He did a split decision with Robert Guerrero. I mean, to stop somebody like that, I definitely think it will jump me up in the ranks for sure.
Minute gone here in round two. James and Molina.
We're seeing a more aggressive Molina here. Usually he's a counterpuncher. I mean, right here, he's going forward, he's digging to the body, he's putting a lot behind shots. He really wants this fight, and I gotta say, Jamal James is actually responding pretty well, keeping patient, keeping calm. I like what I see from both guys.
He really wants it. Molina really wants this fight, but he's taking some chances by doing that. The first round was beautiful. He landed some beautiful body punches and landed some nice left hooks. Look, he already got a little mark under his left eye because he's coming in to take chances. He's taking chances, and that might be a mistake for him.
But do you think he's reckless?
He is. I think he's trying a little bit too hard. He should be fighting the way he did it, maybe the first four or five rounds, and then start picking it up. Right now, he should go back to the way he was the first round.
He did eat a right hand from James.
One thing I noticed about Molina when I sparred him is he has great timing. I think you do have a point here, Robert. He maybe should gauge the timing of the taller, leaner, deceptive power of James here. I mean, he is undefeated. You got to give him some kind of credit coming into this fight. You can't just go in there and take advantage of him.
You talked about the counterpunching. You saw that left hand. Is he countered?
Look, you just said Molina's a good counterpuncher, but he's standing in flat-footed in front of his opponent. Look at that. He should be in and out, side to side. That's where he gets his counterpunches.
Right hand,
he's
James.
Getting hit. He just got hit.
Good counter uppercut by James right there. He was sneaky and caught him right as he was coming in, Molina.
I think Molina this round is giving James his type of fight, the type of fight that James wants. Look, he's flat-footed.
There's a combination by James. Sam, what do you think so far?
I think Molina needs to faint. I think he needs to faint. Jamal, I think he's using his range. He's a rangy guy. If he faints and makes Jamal commit, then that's when he's able to pop onto him.
Hooks at the bell for Javier Molina.
Love it when a fighter says faint.
Yeah, I mean, faint. Listen, if two people are equal, I think whoever's the master of the feints is going to win.
So we take a look at some of the action from that previous round.
Right here, Molina went inside. James did the right thing by trying to hold him on top of the head, but he didn't get a lock on that, so Molina was able to loop some punches around there and steal the round, I think. Maybe.
Up.
When he brings that right foot up, you see his whole body get square. That's when you let him go.
Okay.
All right? Be gone. Or be there. Depends on if you hurt him or not.
Yes, sir.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Turn your eyes on. Keep him peeled. All right?
Yes, sir.
He tries to fight on the inside. That's where he wants to fight. That's why when you tied him up, he started all that stuff, right?
Yeah.
Get back away from him. Use your range. Range finding all night, baby.
Good coach. The coach caught that right foot going to the air, so that's where he's trying to catch him. It's going to be hard for James to catch that because, you know, he's looking at his eyes. But it was interesting that the coach was able to pick that up. It's not easy for a coach to pick up, you know, Molina throwing the right hand and picking up his right foot.
That's his father, Sangera Frazier, who's the trainer of Jamal James. He got the nickname Shango because it was basically from his grandfather. Grandfather used to have a group. He kept the name Shango. It means the African god of lightning, fire, and thunder. He says, that's what I bring when I'm stepping to the ring.
And Brian, we mentioned that both fighters come from a family of boxers, but let's clarify here. James' grandfather was a professional fighter. His father was a professional fighter. Six of his uncles were boxers. So when we say they're fighting families, these guys are really fighting families.
There
by Molina. I think I caught James' attention.
And he also landed a left hook after that. So it was two punches that Molina landed.
Yeah, Javier and his twin, of course, both Olympians. His brother Carlos fought for the world title. There's another double left hook by Molina. There, right hand by Jamal James.
Molina looking more comfortable in there, like he got the timing and the distance of the longer, stronger Jamal James here at 6'2". It takes a couple of rounds to get that distance down.
But as you see, even that James is a taller guy, Molina's not fighting on the inside because he doesn't have to fight on the inside. He can fight on the outside just like he's doing right now, side to side and counter punching.
We are coming up on a minute. Here in round three.
I think Molina's very more effective, you know, having that distance and you know, he's not boxing, he's just having that half distance where he's far enough to make a miss, but close enough to land his punches off that counter.
And one thing to point out is Molina has deceptively long arms. He has a 72, almost 73-inch reach. That's a middleweight reach. I mean, I'm 72. And for him being 5'9", that's deceptive. The shorter fighter has a long reach.
40 seconds here. Left in round three. Here's a right hand to the body by James. Left hook, or right hook, I should say, by James.
Okay.
Double jab right hand.
This is a sharp arm by Molina.
Final seconds here of round three. And it's Molina who closes. Sammy, we know we're going to see you Saturday night. When you talk about Aaron Martinez, give us one thing that you said, you know what, that he has in his toolbox that concerns you.
A lot of pressure. I mean, he brings a lot of pressure. You know, pressure breaks pipes. You know what I mean? But I'm just as pressure. I got a lot of pressure in me too, man. You know, I got to throw a lot of punches as well, and I hit hard. You know, so I think it's going to be a great fight. You know, I intend to stop him, but I mean, you never know, man. One punch can change everything. You know, but I'm very confident in myself, my team. And, you know, we come to fight.
Yeah, it seems like for you, we've seen you obviously here on the PBC, you've always said, listen, I feel like I'm the future of the welterweight division. This is a perfect fight to show that, especially on a national stage.
Absolutely, and he's somebody that's going to bring it, and he's going to help me showcase myself and my abilities. You know, I mean, he's a tough fighter, and we're going to see Saturday who's going to take that W.
Sammy Vasquez, of course, you will see him take on Aaron Martinez before Danny Garcia and Robert Guerrero step into the ring in prime time on Fox Saturday night. Best of luck to you, Sam.
Thank you, sir.
Good to talk to you.
Good luck. Thank you.
This is round four of our main event. Jamal James, he's in the green trunks. Javier Molina in the white trunks, the black trim. Let's take a look at you, the fans, have this one scored thus far. Let's go to throwdownscoring.com. You've given Jamal James a couple of rounds. You've given Javier Molina just one round thus far.
I think Molina took the last round. I think he did enough to steal the round at the end of the round. So I'm 2-1 in favor of Molina.
It's a tight fight, but I think Molina landed the better shots there and closed it off aggressively. I thought he won that round.
And even though he's not the taller guy or the guy with the reach, when he's fighting smart and fighting at that half distance, he's been effective. You know, that's what, you know, the second round he didn't do it, and he was flat for it. Right now he's, you know, he's at least bending his knees and moving around, and I think that's where he's effective.
He's more comfortable now.
He's comfortable.
Now he got the timing down.
Well, we've seen what you, the fans, have it scored thus far. Let's go to our unofficial score. Marco Villegas, as a combination comes from Jamal James. How do you have this one scored thus far, Marco?
Hey, Brian, this is a fight in which we're seeing Molina not being able to consistently land on James, who's showing very excellent footwork. I know the fans gave the round one to James. That's a very close round. But right now I have Jamal James up 3-0 in this fight.
Good job.
Thank you, Marco. So basically, Marco has just basically told you two, your scores are hogwash.
Watch your heads in there, guys.
You got it. You both had it 2-1 Molina. Marco just said, yo, throw that out of the window. I got it 3-0 Jamal James.
They are close enough rounds, but I do think Molina won the first and the third round.
How about that combination by James? Molina comes right back.
So did I, Robert. It's because shots like that, the punch that Molina just landed right there to the body, those are vicious shots. Those are effective shots. Those are better than three or four jabs that land at half point. So I think Molina's doing really well here. They're both doing really well.
How about James? He caught him and then steps away. There's another right to the body.
Jamal has like a herky, jerky, lanky style. He reminds me of a Bob Foster, kind of. Like the power comes in the end. And he does have power. He asked James, he said, hey, listen, I got deceptive power. If I land, I'm going for the knockout.
He did say that. He said, if I hurt Molina, I'm going to stop him. There's a left hook by Molina. 5 seconds of round four.
Time. That was a good round. That was a good round by James right there. He landed a solid right hand to the chin, ended it with two jabs. Molina came back with a vicious body shot. Whether it was enough to win the round, who knows? The worst I have it is 3-1.
All right. What round?
Five. Welcome back. You're watching our main event here on Toe to Toe Tuesday. Javier Molina, he's a former Olympian, taking on the unbeaten Jamal James. Folks, we are commercial free for the rest of this fight.
I mentioned earlier Molina needed to get out of character and put some early rounds in the bank. The fans don't have it that way. The judges might not have it that way, but I've given him at least two rounds so far.
And you also said you love it when fighters faint. And how about Jamal James starting this round out with some feints and then going to the jab?
Guys got to watch your heads.
Not only that, I mentioned that to Sammy Vasquez too, for a young fighter to say
that. Headbutt, no cut, Mark. Headbutt, no cut.
You heard that referee Taylor telling headbutt, no cut. He's told both fighters to watch their heads. Oh, that one looks a little low, look like, by Molina. Came back with a left hook up top.
See, those are the punches that I'm looking at. Those are the ones I'm watching. They're hurting me. So when I see or hear that people don't give them credit and I'm giving them credit for these rounds, I don't see that. Those are some vicious shots to the body that really take a lot out of your opponent.
Fading. Two-punch combination by James. Halfway point. Couple of left hooks to the body by James.
One thing James has been doing, he comes back right after he gets hit. So he's not giving Molina a chance to actually take control of this fight. James is the undefeated fighter here. He's the one that has a lot to lose. So he comes right back when he thinks that Molina is taking advantage.
That's one thing Molina's not doing. When James lands a couple of punches, Molina just goes back and doesn't throw back. So that might be in favor of James.
That might be influencing the judges in the fight.
Crowd chanting Molina. Under a minute here, round five. There's a right to the body by James again.
Those are two good body shots right there. Straight rights to the body.
Nothing back from Molina.
And nothing back from Molina. They take it out of you. This is a good round by James so far.
Nice. 30 seconds now left here in round five.
Jab from Molina wouldn't hurt him. I think he's doing. He stopped throwing his jab, and since then, you know, this round is right off. James.
There's an overhand right by Molina.
Molina took this round off.
Time.
Oh, James made him take it off.
That was a better round. It's a close round. That was a really close round. Molina's atrás. Hey, Javier, that was a close round.
Molina's trying to go out. That was a little bit low, but he landed some good punches after that. Right hand, left hook to the head. You know, that's what he needs to do. He needs to stay on him, throw more than one punch. If he's looking for one punch at a time, it's not going to happen. He needs to throw more than one punch at a time.
Yeah. Okay, let's go. Watch out for his right hand. That's why he's throwing the right hand. And watch, he's changing it to the body. Okay? I need your hand. You're looking for one shot. Don't, yeah. Do you understand what I'm saying? Come on, Javier. Come on, Javier. Let's go, man. Wake up. Wake up, Javier. Let's go, man. It's a close round, okay?
I got this one.
How do you feel? All right? Time's good. Let's go.
That's his trainer, Arnolfo Bravo. They've been together for seven fights. Keep in mind, since his loss about 5 years ago, Molina on an eight-fight win streak. He gives a lot of credit to his new trainer. James is unbeaten.
And he told him the right instructions. You know, he's holding back. He's throwing one punch at a time. He needs to throw more punches. You know, he needs to do that. He can't just win a fight by landing one punch. And if you don't have the power to knock him out, you gotta throw more punches.
We are at the halfway point of this fight. It's scheduled for 10.
It was the right instructions by this coach, because if you're halfway through and you already have some concern, even if it's not a lot of concern in a tight fight, you want to wake your fighter up. These are important rounds in the midway through the fight.
Robert, I want to go back to what we talked about, keys to victory. One of the things you talked about with James staying off the ropes, using his range as he adhered to those edicts.
You know, he's not doing it because he's not the one boxing. You know, it looks like Molina's the one backing up. James is the one, you know, taking a step forward, but he's using that reach. You know, he has definitely stepped away from the ropes and using that jab, you know, those long punches. That's key to victory right there. So he keeps that jab going. Jab that Molina hasn't thrown in a while.
Scoping some punishment there, showing some defense.
Every time Molina gets those chances, he needs to take advantage of it. Throw punches, throw body shots, throw the hooks to the head. He needs to stay busy.
Solid right hand there by James.
Nice kind of right hand.
I think we're seeing a little bit of frustration in Molina. He's having a hard time landing punches, and he looks a little frustrated now.
I was about to say that, Robert. This is the first round that I could say Jamal is actually in control here, and he's frustrating Molina. Molina started off with a bang, but, I mean, this is a 10-round fight, and he has a long way to go, and midway through, you can see the frustration in Molina's face already.
Coming up on a minute here, round six. This is the third 10-round fight. There's a right hand by Molina. the claw. And Molina, as he goes with a left hook to the body.
That's what Molina needs to take advantage of. He needs to stay on him and throw more than one punch, because one punch is not enough. He needs to throw three, four punch combinations.
James comes back with a right.
See, that's so tough about judging these rounds, because so far for 2 minutes, almost 2.5 minutes, James was in control of that fight, but one big punch can sway the judges. It's all about effective punches that night.
20 seconds now, here round six. Final seconds. Molina trying to get on the inside of Jamal James. Misses with a couple of hooks.
James was in control most of that round. Right here, he feinted a left, came back with a right hand that landed solid on Molina. And Molina came back with a big ooh punch, like we call it, where the whole crowd goes ooh. And is that enough for the judges to give him a round? Looking at it, I'd say that I would still give this round to James.
I would too.
How do you feel, man? You want this fight?
Yeah.
You want this fight?
Yeah.
You want to win? You want to win this fight?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. We need to win these rounds, okay? Yeah. Coming up, okay? Let's go.
Land something. Step over.
Let's go.
Stay in front of him.
Let's go, Javier.
He's got to make something happen.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Sir.
You hear everybody quiet. Yeah. That means they ain't in the game. All right.
Let's go to our unofficial score, Marco Villegas, as we take a look at his scorecard, and he's got Jamal James up four on Javier Molina. This is round seven, scheduled for 10. You heard the corner of Molina saying, listen, you got to do it. Push the action.
And in the corner of James, they told him something that my trainer tells me. Whenever the crowd is quiet and the other side is quiet, you're doing your job correctly. Keep it up.
Molina needs to pick his punch a little bit better. Like I said, throw combinations. He's throwing one punch at a time. He's landed a couple of overhand right hand, but I don't think that's enough to win the fight. He needs to throw combinations, step in, get closer, and throw short three, four punch combinations down the middle, not too wide.
There's a left hook. Double left hook by the way to the body, then upstairs.
See, he lands two beautiful punches and he backs up. I think he should stay on James and throw more punches, throw combinations. I don't know if it's him getting tired or frustration, because the corner's telling him exactly the same thing. You gotta throw more punches.
And here comes James. Combinations. Backs Molina up now. Here's his right hand.
Maybe he's feeling some power, because James did tell us he has deceptive power that doesn't get translated in his record. Maybe he's feeling the power here, Robert.
Maybe he is.
James is 18-0. 9 of those wins have come by knockout.
A shot there by James around the guard of Molina.
Look, every time Molina steps in and throws a beautiful body punch, he lands, but he doesn't throw nothing after. Look at that. He doesn't throw. And James doesn't throw back. So that's what Molina needs to do. Stay on him, throw more punches. Every time he backs up, look, he gets hit by the jab. And he's
going to
be getting hit over and over like that. He needs to pick it up.
First time for Jamal James fighting here in California. Second time on national television. There's another right hand. Sends Molina to the corner. Seconds left here, round seven.
Good left hand counter by Molina. I wish he would have turned it over a little bit more. It would have been more effective.
Yeah, I landed good, but it was more like a slap kind of punch.
In the seventh round, the steam starts coming off of punches.
There's a right hand.
Good run by Jamal James here controlling the action.
time right there, guys.
As Molina started, you know, he walks in, throws a nice right to the body, and it seemed like James was hurt, but I don't think James was hurt. Landed a nice body shot there, but I don't think that hurt him. And James, look, James landed those straight punches. Every time Molina backs up and every time James throws punches, James is landing. Pretty simple. It doesn't make it any easier for James. And that's Molina making it easy.
You gotta try to steal around at the end. When you hear us say go, you got to go. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Either move or do something. Don't let him just stand there and do nothing. Because he's hitting you on your arms. There ain't nothing happening.
Right.
You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Let's go, man. Keep it up. Come on, same thing. Pressure, come on.
Here's a look at the punch stats through seven rounds. James has landed nearly 120 punches. Molina, just 54. This is round eight.
And those numbers are telling the story. I think going into the eighth round now, Molina is not quite desperate yet, but he needs to do something big in order to get back into this fight.
He's falling behind on the scorecard already. You know, I think he's on, you know, the first round and maybe the third, but yeah, after that, I think it's all Jamal James. Nice right hand by
James. There's the right hand by James. Javier Molina, part of that 2008 Olympic team. I mean, you talked about Molina, Deontay Wilder, Gene Warren. The list goes on and on of all those guys who are just so talented. Demetrius Andrade, Gary Russell Jr. He says, when I look at what these guys have done in the pros, it just motivates me. I want to be at their level. I feel like that loss set me back. I need a win tonight.
And Jamal James also says something like that because he may not have made the Olympic team, but he looks at guys like Errol Spence and Sammy Vasquez, Sean Porter, Javier Molina, even the guy he's fighting, Javier, right now. He's saying, I fought with these guys in the amateurs. Yeah. I should be at that level.
Yeah, James told us, look, I fought Danny Garcia twice.
That's right.
In the amateurs. He goes, I'm headlining tonight. He's headlining Saturday night. I got to get to that level.
I think slowly he is getting to that level. You know, he's very tall. He's a little awkward. So all that makes it difficult for any of those fighters that you guys just mentioned.
Here's a cut on this right eye of Javier Molina. Short left hook by James.
I don't think the cut is going to frustrate him anymore. I think missing the punches, falling behind on the scorecards, I think the frustration already set in. The blood is just going to be secondary.
Under a minute here in round eight.
Good shot there, by Molina. I see
Mags! Mags! Keep him out of fight! Keep him quiet!
Good jab there by James, keeping him away.
30 seconds now. 1-2 by James.
James is on a roll now.
He's patrolling the distance of where this fight is being fought. And the ring. There's a 1-2 right on the button by James.
That's the biggest punch that I've seen so far in the fight. I think James landed that with solid aggression and did land it solid.
It was a beautiful punch that he landed, and look, followed by some body punches, but also very effective.
And comes back upstairs. Good round for Jamal James.
Here we see James landing that right hand I was just talking about. Missed that left hook, but that right hand did its damage already. Solid punch. It's kind of a half right hand, half right hook, but it landed solid, went downstairs to the body, backed up. Really nice.
Landed that right hand, followed up with three more punches.
All right? The body shots was killing it.
Box Fight Week off to a great start here tonight. Now Saturday, primetime boxing returns to Fox. First time in nearly 20 years. It should be an all-out war. Undefeated Danny Garcia. You heard from him earlier tonight. taking on former champion Robert Guerrero. The biggest boxing event of the month. It's Saturday, 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern, only on your local Fox affiliate. This is our main event. Jamal James in those green trunks taking on Javier Molina.
When we asked James in the fighter meeting why he didn't look spectacular against Juan Carlos Abreu, he said because Abreu didn't come really to win the fight, and it's hard to look good against fighters that don't come to win. Even though it was a good fight, he came through with the win. Right here, I think he's having the same problem. He may not be looking for the knockout, but he surely wants it.
He was certainly tested, faced adversity in that fight, as you pointed out, Robert. Got dropped in that fight, came back and ended up dropping his opponent, and cruised to a unanimous decision.
And now stepping up in level and competition, he's doing a great job. You know, he might not be the best style fighter, you know, that the crowd might like, but he's effective. He's doing enough to win the fight.
Big overhand right there by Jamal James.
James went to a home run here.
He sure enough did. And you know, Sergio, you know Javier Molina well. He talked a lot about, I need this fight. He has to this fight. In his words, all about redemption. If he loses this fight, how does that set him back?
I hate to say it because it took him so much to get back. I mean, he faced so much adversity from breaking his hand, having to get hand surgery, everything that he adjusted outside the ring. But if these big fights, this is his first main event. He needed to make a statement. He's fighting a guy that's undefeated, unknown, and he's really getting overwhelmed by the bigger, stronger James here, the undefeated James. This is a big setback for Molina.
No, I could think Molina could bounce back with a couple of fights.
Stop,
you know,
right
this is a fight that he had to take. He had to step it up. But it's a style that just doesn't favor him. You know, James is way too tall. The reach advantage is against him. So if he comes back strong with a couple of good wins, he'll be back on top. You know, if his management team does a good job picking the points. I think this was a bad pick for him. For his big fight, big main event on TV, should have been something different.
Under a minute here in round 9.
That's a great point, Robert. I really feel that matchmaking is key for prospects.
As a right hand. But at some point, you got to get tested.
That's exactly
what
I was going to
say. You're going to take that next step like he wants, so you got to get tested.
Not only that, but it's Molina's hometown. So James came over here, and he's the visitor. So he's the one putting on a show here. He's the one that's stealing this decision.
That's where the matchmaking comes. They should have matched, right. They should have matched him against somebody that's going to make him look better.
But that's not toe-to-toe Tuesday.
Right? That's exactly right.
That's right.
That's what toe-to-toe Tuesday is all about. Seeing if you're time, really a contender.
And now we're gonna lose the fucking fight.
Yes, sir. All right. I want to see some combinations.
Yes, sir.
The back leg wasn't moving equal. It was staying back. Okay? We worked on that. Equal movement.
Yes, sir.
You understand me?
Yes, sir.
All right. This is your round. It's your fight.
Yes, sir.
You got to work for it, man. This is you in this house.
He coming. Yes,
you
sir.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
Don't let him be stealing nothing. Be careful on that side. I told you that.
Mm-hmm.
I see your shoulder ready for it. All right? Be careful on the side and keep using that jab.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. This is you.
You can see the father. He trains Jamal James. This is the final round. Let's go to our unofficial score. Marco Villegas' scorecard. He has got Jamal James a 5. He's giving him the past couple of rounds. He did get Molina. Round 7. This is the 10th and final round. Crowd chanting Molina's name.
Molina, who's not known as a power puncher, needs a knockout to win here. He has the crowd behind him. The problem is he has James in front of him.
Who continues to control the range and the distance of this fight.
that's all James needs to do. Keeps that jab, you know, fight that distance and win an easy round. You know, keep it like that. He doesn't need to take any chances. If he tries to take chances, there's a chance that he gets caught. There's no need for that. He just keeps that jab in his face and do that for 2 more minutes, and he goes out with a good win.
Minute gone here in round 10. Robinson, you talked about matchmaking. And, you know, James talked about how he wants to fight some of the top level fighters in the welterweight division. If you were in his corner, how soon could you see Jamal James in the ring against some of those guys?
I think a few more fights. You know, this is a good experience for him. Molina is one of those tough kids, but he needs a few more fights. I'd say maybe 3 or 4 more fights before he even steps up with any of those top 10 or 15 fighters.
Molina not fighting like he's been running on points, not even making an effort to try to steal lightning in a bottle. But Jamal James, credit to him, because he kept the former Olympian at bay for 10 rounds. This is a big step up for Jamal James.
It is. Kept his game plan, did everything he had to do.
And we are at 1 minute left here in this fight of our main event. Jamal James is out of Minneapolis, Minnesota. Unbeaten. They've already considered him one of the best prospects that ever come out of the state. He said basically in 3 decades. We've had some fighters to come out of that area. Caleb Truex is the one that's come out.
And I was a bit skeptical when I heard Minnesota, but you know what? Minnesota, if you're watching, you got something special in this young man. Jamal Shango James, remember that name. He looked pretty good tonight.
Let's see if Molina can catch him with a punch. He's got 20 seconds. He's got 10 seconds now. Shango.
Closing the show.
Yes, he is.
Time right there, guys.
The fight.
Good job.
Well, the judge's official decision is in. Let's find out who won this fight. Here's Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds, we go to the scorecards. Here are your score totals. Judge at ringside, Dr. Lou Moret, has the contest 99-91. Judge Sergio Caiz sees the contest 98-92. And Judge Zachary Young scores the bout 97-93. All for your winner by unanimous decision, Jamal Shango James.
Jamal James. Now 19-0 as he gets the unanimous decision and beats Javier Molina.